Module 3, Supplementary Contracts, or Riders. Here in Module 3, we will learn about supplementary contracts and life insurance, otherwise known as riders. Move on to learn more. Let's start this by finding out what a rider is. Riders are supplementary contracts that provide additional benefits for a minimal cost. They need a basic plan to be attached to. That's why they're called riders. They are term insurance because they are applicable only for a limited period. They may be enforced only until age 60 of the insured. Types of riders. Let's start with a waiver of premium on disability. This is usually attached to the basic plan in order to waive payments upon total disability and permanent disability. Total disability in insurance is defined as the insured being unable to engage in any gainful occupation for which he is suited by profession, education, and experience. For example, a surgeon who has lost his hand can no longer perform operations. He may find employment as a professor in a teaching hospital or university, but because his education, profession, and experience did not prepare him to be a professor, he is then considered totally disabled. Total disability can be automatic in the cases of insured individuals who have obvious physical impairments, like being blind in both eyes or having lost or not having both legs. Permanent disability is a condition that lasts continuously for at least 6 months. The 6 months is considered as a waiting period. When the waiting period is over, all previous and successive premiums falling due will be waived until the disability persists. When the customer is able to recover, premium payment will resume. The company has the right to check the medical status of the customer. Types of riders. The payer's benefit. When a life insurance plan is bought for a child, a payer's benefit is usually attached. Premiums are waived when the payer of the child's insurance either dies or becomes totally and permanently disabled. This supplement is attached to policies with the insured at an age below 18 to ensure their plans continue even with the demise of their payer. However, premiums may be waived at age 60 of the payer or upon the insured turning 21, whichever comes first, after which the rider terminates. If there are future premiums to be paid after the rider expires, the insured, if at legal age, may continue payment. Otherwise, a contingent owner may continue payment of the plan. Types of riders. Accidental death benefit. This provides an additional amount if the cause of death is accidental. Before claims can be paid under this supplement, there are conditions that must be met. Death must occur 90 days after the time of the accident. The reason being, the longer the period before death occurs, it'll be more difficult to prove that it was solely caused by the accident. Death must occur before termination of the rider at age 60. Death is solely and directly due to the accident and independent of other causes. The company may determine true cause of death. We determine the proximate cause by probing sufficiently and analyzing the facts surrounding the case. Take the case of a man hit by a car while crossing the street. Add this to the scene. The person was holding his chest and couldn't move. Did he have a heart attack which immobilized him and led to the car hitting him? Or was he hit by the car, had a heart attack, and eventually died? The company can conduct further investigation to determine the true cause of death. If it's found that the proximate cause of death is the car hitting him, causing the attack and eventual death, the benefits of the accidental death benefit rider will be paid to his beneficiaries. Rider limitations. Criminal act leading to death. If an insured individual, for example, steals a car, that is carjacking or grand theft auto. If this act leads to his death, only the basic plan is paid. Exclusions. Other exclusions include suicide, murder and assault, acts of nature, war or acts of war. Types of riders. Term rider. Additional coverage on top of the basic plan with the least initial cost can be provided by a term rider. It pays death benefits due to natural or accidental causes. The most common type is the family income rider. This is a decreasing term. Types of rider. Guaranteed insurability rider. When this is attached to the basic plan, it allows the insured to purchase additional coverage or policies without the need for evidence of insurability. Riders make the basic plan more comprehensive and best suited to the customer's needs. Riders supplement the basic benefits provided by most life insurance plans, making the insurance solution comprehensive to answer specific needs of customers. Because they provide very specific benefits, riders expire at a specific period, usually age 60. Terminate when cash value of the basic plan is used up. Do not accumulate cash values. May only be purchased at a stated age and are subject to exclusions. Knowledge of the plans and riders enable you to perform total needs selling. You have just completed Module 3, Supplementary Contract.